So, this week on Manic Mechanic, I am talking to you about why we bought a four-post lift. Simply put, one of the main reasons we bought a four-post lift was we wanted to have something for storage and for filming. And we wanted a four-post lift because we've got some really big plans for some of the cars here on Manic Mechanic.
Autocrafters, your source for Cougar, Falcon, Fairlane, Full-Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
We have a 69 Fairlane that's getting a 4R70W transmission. I want to be able to do driveline adjustments, which I can do with this lift that I can't do with a two-post lift. We're going to be working on a 64 Falcon hardtop that's getting a 347 small block and a modern driveline 5-speed assembly. Once again, I want to be able to make sure that my driveline adjustments are correct because we're adding a 9-inch rear axle to that car, so that I can actually, you know, make sure it's not going to vibrate going down the road. Best way to be able to do that is a four-post lift. The other reason is filming. It just makes it a lot easier to film when I have a four-post lift or even a two-post lift to shoot with on the undercarriage of the cars. One of the problems that we ran into in the past is, especially working on that 67 Mustang Fastback, we just had too little space and too many people working on the car underneath it. It got to be a real hassle trying to figure out how to film the things we needed to film to show you guys what we wanted you to see without having a lift. Then we made the cataclysmic error of going to my friend Larry's house and using his four-post lift to shoot the seal redo on our C4 transmission in our 69 Fairlane wagon. Put it up in the air on the lift and it was magical. You could put lights in places. You could actually see what you were doing. Really cool, wild angles of photography that we heretofore had not been able to achieve. Thus began the plan for the lift. The other thing is, it's just easier for me to work on the undercarriage of the cars and not lay down, have to get up and get tools. My back is such that I don't really like getting up and down a lot. It hurts at the end of the day. I'm not making excuses for my past sins, which are many and varied, but the one that caused this was actually riding dirt bikes when I was a kid. So, huzzah, that's another reason for it. The other reason is storage. We are running out of places to put cars and keep them indoors. We have to do an incredible amount of elephant dancing around here to get cars out of the shop, to get cars in the shop. We have Bill Rodish's 70 Camaro here. We have my 72 Ford pickup truck. We have the 72 Mach 1. We have the 64 Falcon. We have the 65 Ranchero. We have a 72 Reno on the way, which is going to be featured here, doing stuff on it with parts from Autocrafters. There's a lot going on that's going to require us to have storage space. Four-post lifts are awesome for storage, where two-post lifts just aren't. You cannot get a two-post lift with drip trays because, let's face it, it's old. And if it's old, it's gonna leak fluids. Trust me. I know about old things dripping fluids. So, that being the case, four-post lift works much better for that. One of the other reasons I like a four-post lift over a two-post lift is the fact that if you're going to be doing things like driveline modifications to a car, where you're putting, say, a 4R70W in a 69 Fairlane wagon, which is coming, you're going to want to be able to set up your driveline angles with stuff, and it's a lot easier to do that on a four-post lift. Two-post lifts, you can't set up drivelines because everything's hanging down, and it's not going to be in the correct ride position. With a four-post lift, you can set that thing on the tires, check your driveline angle, and make sure that everything is lining up the way it needs to for the car to go down the road and not vibrate. Same thing with the 64 Falcon hardtop we're working on. That's going to have a 5-speed for modern driveline, and then we're going to be trying to put a 9-inch with that, so when we do all of that together, guess what? Same problem. You need to have something to be able to set the driveline up. Four-post lift will give you that because you can drive up on the runways, set the car where it needs to be, bada bing, bada boom, you're ready to go. One of the things that people will tell me is, well, with a two-post lift, you can change the tires easier. Okay, You got me. You can change the tires easier with a two-post lift. Not sure it's really worth all that. One of the other things is this, is we want the mobility that this lift from Wildfire offers. It comes with four casters. You can move this sucker all over the shop if you want to. If I want to put it here, I can put it here. If I want to put it back behind where I've got my cameras set up right now, guess what? I can do that. I can even do that, I think, with the car on there. I'm not totally sure about that, but I'm pretty sure these casters are rated so that I can put a car on here, move it over to the other side of the shop, bring another car in if I so desired. So mobility is an issue. With a two-post lift, I am stuck with wherever we ended up putting that two-post lift. And my main storage area for this lift and cars is going to be back behind the stairs, which is a little tight and hard to get to for working. We can move the lift out here, put the car up in the air, and voila, we've got it going on. Now we have like 12 or 13 foot ceilings in this shop, so we have the ability to get the thing pretty much all the way up in the air that you may not have in your shop, but you know, for us, this is the way to do things. One of the other things about the four-post lift over a two-post lift, one of the reasons we went with a four-post, is I feel like, this is just a personal feeling, this is not something that has been proven by science, I feel like that the four-post lift is just a little safer in operation for people who are novices that have never played around with a lift. I have seen professionals perfectly screw up putting a car in the air with a two-post lift, have to put the car back on the ground, readjust the car's position because they may have taken the engine out, or maybe they've pulled the gas tank out and there's no fuel in it from where they were working on it before, and a car is tilty and really scarily mobile on those four little pads. When your car is on a four-post lift with the tires on it, you're not going to have those issues of safety as much. Yes, the four-post lifts can possibly collapse if they're not lifted correctly. Both of these things are all operator errors, but I can train somebody better to know how to set up a car on a four-post than I can how to set up a car on a two-post lift. So that's another thing that really kind of went into me doing this, because we have a lot of young people working here. Cam and I are pretty experienced at this stuff, know how to put things up on a lift. Younger guys just plain don't. So we would have to go in and do some training with them with a two-post lift. Do I dislike two-post lifts? No. I think two-post lift would be great. I would love to have one in one bay and one in the other. So we had a four-post lift in one bay, we had a two-post lift in another bay, because there are things that I would prefer to do on a two-post lift. There aren't many of them that I can do on a two-post lift that I can't do on a four-post, though. I have had guys write in and say, well, what if you want to do an exhaust system on the car? Well, honestly, I would rather have the car sitting on the ground and be able to jack the body up to move pipes through the rear axle area than to have it on a two-post lift, be able to easily thread that stuff through, and then put it back on the ground, only to find out that I have an interference issue somewhere in the exhaust system. It can be an issue with that. Oil changes aren't any easier on a two-post lift. Transmission change-out stuff, obviously, we've done it. It's just as easy on the four-post lift as it is on the two-post lift. So I kind of go back and forth on whether the two-post or the four-post is better. I think it depends on what you like. It's almost kind of like the thing with Chevy versus Ford, or Chevy versus Mopar, or Ford versus Mopar. What do you enjoy working on and working with? I've had great success. I've used four-post lifts since I first got into this stuff, working back at Mustang Monthly back in the early 2000s, the late 90s, and I really enjoyed working with a nice four-post lift. I never felt like it was a detriment. And the four-post lift for us gives us a lot of things that we don't have with the two-post lift in mobility. Now, what I want to talk lastly about is when you're putting a lift in, two of the things that kind of worry me about two-post lifts and four-post lifts. One of those things is, how thick is your concrete? If your concrete on your floor is under 4 inches thick, you're going to have a possible problem with it cracking and breaking away when you put the pressure of a vehicle on there on top of a lift that's already fairly heavy. If you get a good quality lift, guess what? It's not going to be the lightest thing in the world. So you need a minimum of 4 inches of concrete underneath the lift when you're using it. You want it to be set to about 3,000 PSI of strength in the concrete. And usually, most garages are okay for that. Now, I've read that with two-post lifts, you want it to be exactly the same. You want 4 inches of concrete, 3,000 PSI concrete underneath the lift. My thing on that is that I would want to know that I know that. In other words, I would want to make sure that it's 4 inches of concrete underneath that. With a four-post lift, you're not putting all your weight in two central post positions like you are with a two-post lift. With a two-post, you've got two real small spots of pressure. With a four-post lift, you're spreading that load out over four different locations on your concrete floor. Not saying that's a better or worse situation, it's just something that I think you want to make sure that you know what you've got going on underneath where those are at, because the last thing you want to do is to put your $40,000 classic car up in the air on a two-post lift or even on a four-post lift and have the floor crack and break underneath it and send the car sailing toward the floor. Because Murphy's Law dictates that if it's going to sail, it ain't going to sail at the bottom. It's going to wait till you get it all the way up at the top to kind of take that nosedive. Well, this is a real quick little video I wanted to do just to give you guys an idea of why we're doing what we're doing with the lift that we got from Wildfire. This lift is going to become a very integral part of what we do around here. You're going to start seeing us do more heavy lifting as far as transmission stuff, driveline videos, things like that, because we do now have this lift. Oh, we got some exciting news too, folks. We've got stickers now. These stickers are automotive vinyl. They can go on the outside of the glass of your car. So if you want to put them on your classic cars or you put them on your car that you drive to work every day so people know who you support, you can get these by being a part of our Patreon account and subscribing at a $10 a month level. You also will get a mention on the show when you subscribe at that level. So please check out Patreon. Our Patreon account goes to help offset some of our costs. I know we have advertisers, but that's really not enough to offset how much these children that come in here and work with us on a weekly basis eat. They eat a lot. I'm not kidding. Like 4, 6, 8 pizzas. It's crazy. Never seen that much food going out in my life, even when I was a kid. So anyway, do that, and then also go out and like and subscribe to the channel. When you subscribe to the channel, be sure to hit the little bell next to it because that gives you notification every time one of our videos goes live. So anytime it's an Autorestomod or a Manic Mechanic video, you'll be notified of that by clicking that little bell. Another thing I want you to do is go out and comment on this video. Tell me what you think. Tell me if I'm an idiot for liking a four-post lift. I'm not going to believe you. But you can tell me that. It's okay. I'm a big boy. I can take the heat. So, without further ado, all right, that's all we have time for this week on Manic Mechanic. We've got a lot of stuff going on around here. We need to finish this thing up. But I wanted to give you a real quick rundown of what our thought process was on the lift. So, do us a favor, come back next time and watch us, and we'll see you on down the road.